time of man following man and exalting man is over. It's time for us to turn back to God and exalt Him and His Son. And tonight, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, that's coming again. So the 120 drums will be released here as a sacred vision of the Lord to bring realignment. And when they merge with the 120 shofars, it has been said that it will bring an awakening to our land once again. And we are regrouping. 120 is to regroup, to bring the harvest in. For Yeshua has said that none should perish and all should have an everlasting life. This is to bring the harvest as regrouping as the people of North America. So let's do this and release it in Yeshua's name.
Yeah. As we do this, we want to release today that Linda Prince, that John Paul Jackson, many of you have heard of him, a great prophet who died prematurely, called her and said he was caught up into heaven in a visitation. And an angel of the Lord said, every revival has had an instrument that led that revival. And he talked about the piano and the other instruments. But he said the next great awakening will be with the drum. I believe that when Linda said to me, I didn't know this just a week and a half ago. She said she had a visitation that when 120 drums and 120 shofars were released, it would release a great awakening. I want us to believe God and release faith all over this place.
The native peoples of this land. The word Azusa is derived from the native names of the Tonga, the Gabrielina Tonga. So I've asked, here is our elder, Julia Bogany, who's representing the chief, Anthony Morales. And she's gonna open up with a prayer in her language, and then the shofars are gonna watch Jason, and the drummers watch Aaron over here, and then just wait for the blow, okay?
We're going to open the gates of heaven today. With a prayer that Jesus gave us. Our Father, which is Iyona, Iyote, Tokubanga, Ha, Hoyu, Yukoi, Mudwanya, Morari, Mokima, Kokupa, Ma, Mawishme, Meyi, Ohod, Oya, Tokupad, Hamare, Ione, Mahare, Witame, Koi, Ohubone, Oyobana, Momahai, Mii, Evare, Oyana, Eyohino, Eyoha, Koi, Yame, Ami, Ita, Mohami, Koi, Ha, Monuha, Yimane, Hare, the Lord's Prayer.
Shofar is ready. Tekiya! Teruah!
Thank you. Stretch your hands towards heaven. Lift up your heads, O ye gates. Look up to heaven. Lift up your heads, O ye gates. And be ye lifted up, you everlasting doors. And the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord God strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates. And be ye lifted up, you everlasting doors. That the King of glory may come in. We speak to the gates of this land. We speak to the gates of this nation. We thank you, Abba. We welcome you, King of glory, from the western shores of North America to the western gate of Jerusalem. We welcome the King of glory.
Responded to the Lord Jesus Christ. And out of those 500, 300 were first time giving their hearts to the Lord. Everywhere we've gone, it is impossible to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ in Alaska right now without people getting saved. It is Alaska's time. It has begun.
Yes, Lord.
We are seeing evidence of revival, of an awakening. Hundreds, thousands even are being swept into the kingdom of God. And there is a unified movement that's happening in Alaska. Pastors, leaders, missionaries, and Christians coming together for one purpose: to make Jesus known, to reach every man and boy and girl all across Alaska. And it's called One Day, and we believe that by 11/11/17 that we will reach every town, every city, every village in Alaska. So this is our part. This is our part in the greater picture of what's happening here.
What we don't, what you don't know, is that it's 200 years ago, right here in Azusa, not Azusa Street, but up here. A native gal that had the gift of healing. She prayed for a chief. The chief got healed. He renamed her Azusa, which means blessed miracle. And the word spread all over the region. If you could just get to Azusa, you could get healed. What are the chances that 200 years later, God would pour his spirit out on Azusa Street? There is a well that began with the native people. Come on. Themselves a year to pray for Azusa Street. This young man from the Crow tribe has just finished 40 days of water fasting, crying out for their people. The warriors are coming. Lift your voice and give a shout for the God.
Becoming the awakened.
This is what I want you to do right now, all across this place. I want you to get in small groups, and I want you to begin to pray for the native revival and awakening to come. Get in small groups right now and begin to pray. Engage right now. We're unified in united prayer. Just keep praying.
Father, the giant has awoken, and I say that you heal the land, redeem the land that has bloodshed on it. Cleanse it, Father, cleanse it. Release us, Father. I pray that my generation awakes and return their life back to Christ.
All over this place, begin to pray. Send the fire again. Go ahead. Send the fire.